even about. You can't have. Stand before us. When we have. No one has. That we may have. For standing. When we were back in the church, people were dying every week. It's a shame. We got this book, we got that book, we got this face, we got that space, all this technology, and people are dying by the hundreds. Back at the old church, there were no social messages, there were no social networks, there was no internet, but guess what, there was prayer, and somebody would say, God, the Moses didn't understand it, but they knew what they were saying, they was talking to an omnipresent God, but the mothers, their intellect, they would say, Father, go down on Broadway, my son, sling needles in his arm, go down in the Philly, my daughter is messing up, go up to New York, my husband turned left me, and my mother would stop, she would say, I'm gonna leave you. In the hand of the Lord, and she will never look back, because she has power. Let's go back to church when no one could sit in the service with the power of God moving. Not be touched, you may not receive the Holy Ghost, but something about that service made you cry, something about that service made you think, you try to get out, but the mother would let you, she would say, from the tears, don't let it be said, too late. Go back to church when the people were not too proud to get down on their knees. The floor didn't have carpet. The floor had ceramic tiles. And they got down on their knees. And they stayed there until something happened. But they heard. Jesus said, marry me in the sin of Jerusalem until you get tired. That's not what he said, but until you begin to lose. Let's go back to church. When preachers didn't worry about a title, come on somebody, let's go back to church. When preachers didn't mind preaching together on the platform, now if you're not the main speaker, you're too busy. Let's go back to church. Because he said, don't forsake the assembly of ourselves as a man of some age. And he also said, behold, how good and how pleasant the brethren dwell together in unity. I need you. Let's oxygen trap. I'm a choking hell, a dying hell, not engaged hell, but I'm a choking hell, a dying hell, in the church building, and sucking in Rome, singing. Say, give me that old hat. I need a new hat. Can you see that sign? You would say, it was good hat for my dear mother. And it's good enough hat for me. It's just like it. Let's go back to church when people didn't have to guess who had the Holy Ghost. Let's go back to the church that believed and see signs to follow them that believed. Let's go back to church. Let's go back to church. When the people would get happy, doing offering time. I'm a little woman touch that. That's why you're looking a bliss right now. But we gotta go back to being cheerful givers. Back in the days when they were looking forward to fundraisers. It seemed like the ones that made the less money raised the most money. We got people wearing gaiters, but they're giving haters. Lord, they're wearing slaves, but they are doing acts with me. You're a snake. Get out of dark started. Let's go back to the church where you was happy. Church when revival time in the middle of the school year. Remember those days? Revival time in the middle of the school year. More classes for the homework. But revival tonight. Went to revival. Can't get out early. But you went to revival. Went home, got a couple hours sleep, woke up on a Friday, took the flesh, got it back, you saw the red mark, but when you looked up, you saw 2 zeros, but thank you to God, there was a 1, in front of 2 zeros, Let's go back to church where we got sick. We didn't want to stay home, but we believe that I could just get my foot into the door. But you was basically saying, if I could just touch the hem of his garment, I can't touch it without his prayer hole. I'm gonna go to the house of prayer for all people, because he was ruined for my trespasses, for my iniquity, for my peace. There's one hill, and with this life, I am healed. Yeah. find money and you go shopping, your first outfit is a church outfit. I don't want to just want some pounds, but when you go back to church, you're finding out if you're blind, your church outfit first. We will take care of the school outfit. We will take care of the work outfit. Because we say, we eat first, the freedom of God, and the righteousness, and all these things. Oh, yeah. John, write to the church at Ephesus. You've done this, very good. You've done that, very good. This, that, the other, very good. Nevertheless, like somebody gets you, you pay your tithe, but you won't live right. Seen on the flying, but you won't live right. He said, nevertheless, I've got somewhat against you. You left your first love. What is he saying? You cheated on God. You became a spiritual harlot. Whether you're man or woman, we can cheat with God. You're a spiritual harlot. Because know ye not, your body is the temple of the living God. If you defile it, you'll destroy it. That's why the old church said, my soul and body, the Lord of God, and we can't touch it. Preaching the gospel, and you preach against it. Then here comes Steve Harvey, telling you fools, act like a woman, think like a man. Something wrong with that, because he took you out of a man, not to act like a man, and we were rather listen to that man. The bishop will tell you, don't give it up. He tells you, give him 90 days, then give him the cookie. No, give him the cookie, then give it up. And some of you will never learn. You keep giving him the cookie. The more cookie he gives, another baby, not enough for the cookie. You end up with more babies than you have cookies. But if my people, which are poor, not my neighbor, not for myself, then you have. Yeah.